Good afternoon. Okay, so sorry for the previous day because I couldn't get any time to check your work. Okay, that I told you to post after solving those numericals. Okay, so without any delay, after 2 minutes, your class will start. Okay, I saw that some of you posted your solution in the group. Why I couldn't get any time yesterday. Okay, so today first we will complete some theoretical portion of module 2, right? And is there any class after this? Hello, is there any class?
No class.
No, sir.
If that extends just 5 minutes or 10 minutes, then you don't have any problem, right? Because
no, sir, you don't have any problem.
Okay, fine. So after 2 minutes, your class will start. Okay, and today we are going to discuss the second module, that is AC circuit. The DC circuit is totally completed. Okay, and with that 2 numericals, it will be complete. Right, fully. Okay, so after 1 minute, your class will start. So let others join, then I will start. Okay, is the screen visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so today we are going to discuss the module 2, that is the AC circuit. Okay, whatever we learned from the module 1, that is based on the DC sources. Okay, here instead of that DC source, we are going to use the AC source. Okay. There are 2 kinds of AC circuits, right? One is single phase, another one is 3 phase. Okay, so what is the difference between single phase and 3 phase? That we will discuss later. First, try to learn what is single phase, because whatever connection we have in our house, that is single phase. Okay, because you see that from a fan, only 2 wire is connected to your switch. Okay, and also in the backside of a switch there are 2 points. Okay, so what is in this module? Here we are going to discuss the representation of sinusoidal waveform. What is peak and RMS value? What is the phasor representation? Next one is what is real power, reactive power, apparent power, and power factor. Next, the analysis of single phase AC circuit consisting of the resistor, inductor, capacitor, and several types of combinations of these elements. Right. Then resonance will be discussed. And in the last, 3 phase balanced circuit and voltage and current relation in star delta connection. Okay, so in this PPT these topics are included. Okay, the difference between AC and DC, representation of sinusoidal waveform, some important terms related to AC waveform, then average value and RMS value calculation, then peak factor, crest factor, form factor, and then some numerical. Okay.
So, what is the difference between AC and DC? The difference is, in case of DC, the magnitude of either current or voltage, both are constant with respect to time. Okay. But in case of DC, it has some frequency with which it can oscillate. Okay, the waveform just go back and forth. That is the difference between the DC and AC. Right. So here you can see the representation of one basic sinusoidal waveform. Okay. This is, in this waveform, the y-axis decides the magnitude. Okay. And the x-axis decides its propagation. Okay. That means how much it is going. Okay. And this one full cycle means, here you can see that from 0 to 180 degree, from this to this point, the waveform is in positive y-axis. Okay, that means whatever value we are getting, that is positive value. Okay, and another one is from 180 degree to 360 degree. This is the negative. Whatever value we are getting, whatever magnitude we are getting, that is negative. But in case of DC, this negative value never happens. Okay. So this combination of one positive cycle, this is called one positive cycle, this 0 to 180, one positive cycle and one negative cycle, it is called periodic time, a full cycle. Okay, and the time required to propagate from 0 to 360, that is called the periodic time or time period, you may say. Okay, and what is the equation? The equation is AT equals to A max, that means the maximum value of this waveform. This is the maximum point, okay, because beyond this point, the curve cannot go. So this A max into sine 2 pi FT. What is this 2 pi F? 2 pi F is called the omega. It is called the angular frequency. This F is called the normal frequency of the waveform, because concept of frequency, concept of time period, already you have, you learned that from 11-12 physics. Okay. This is just a small recapitulation what you learned. So this F unit is hertz. Okay. And when you convert from F to omega, what is the unit of omega? It is radian. Okay. That is called angular frequency. And what is time period? If you can remember, time period is the inverse of the frequency. 1 by F equals to time period. So if your frequency is 50 hertz and our normal frequency in India, okay, our nationwide universal frequency is always 50 hertz. Okay, in Qatar or some that Singapore, Thailand, at that places the frequency is 60 hertz. Okay, but in our nation, the frequency is 50 hertz. So if you know the frequency, you can calculate the time to propagate one full cycle. So 1 divided by 50, that means 0.02. Okay, that is 0.02 second. That is a time period of the signal It may be a voltage or current. Right. So, now, next, what is the characteristics? So, there are three or four characteristics, because based on that values, we can identify the waveform's nature. Right. First one is the period. Okay. What is the period? The length of time, that means the time requires to propagate one full cycle of the waveform. Right. That is called the time period or the periodic time. Next, one is the frequency. The waveform goes back and forth. Right. And that number, how many number it goes back and forth in 1 second, that is basically called the frequency. Okay. Next one is the amplitude. Amplitude is nothing but the magnitude of the waveform. Okay. Here, see, this is one sinusoidal waveform. This is its magnitude plus V. Okay. So what we can say that the magnitude of this waveform is modulus V. That means plus minus V. This is the voltage variation for this waveform, correct? Because see, the voltage can vary from plus V to minus V. Okay, so how can I say that magnitude is V? No, it is wrong. So that's why we always tell that its magnitude is modulus V. That means whatever be its direction, see, it is positive cycle, it is negative cycle. It is positive cycle, it is negative cycle. So whatever be the direction, its maximum magnitude is always modulus V. Okay. Now, this is one complex wave. Why? Because it is the combination of two waves. If you can look clearly. See, if I extend this portion, then you can say that it is the combination of one wave and second wave. So this is the combination of two waves. So the combination of two waves means this portion was also added. Okay. Since this portion was added, that's why this curvature you are getting. Okay, this curvature you are getting. Just like that here. Okay, so this is one type of complex wave. Next one is the triangular wave. Right. Next one is square wave. Okay. All are alternating waveform. Okay, now if I tell you that how the sawtooth waveform looks like. The sawtooth waveform looks like this. Okay, just like our tooth. Okay, it is called sawtooth waveform. Right, just like another form of the alternating waveform. Okay, next one is the relationship that you already know. This relationship you already know. And those who don't know, just see this. Okay. That frequency equals to inverse of the time period. And conversely, we can say that periodic time or time period equals to 1 by frequency. Okay. So, sometime in the numerical, they didn't mention the frequency of the waveform. So, at that time, you have to check that what is the time period given in the system, in the numerical. Okay. You have to check. Sometimes the frequency is given, but the time period is not given. So from that relationship between frequency and periodic time, you have to check which value is not given and you have to convert vice versa. Okay. So what is the periodic time of 50 Hertz waveform? That is 1 by F, that is 0.02 second or 20 milliseconds. Similarly, another numerical is given. Okay, this one is easy. Now, next one is the average value of the waveform. What is the meaning of average value? Average speed already you had calculated in speed, velocity, work, power chapter in physics. So what is the meaning of average value? Can anyone say what is the meaning of average value, or you already learned average speed? So what is the meaning of that?
Sum of all the numbers by total number of observations.
Exactly. So here, at each point, take the voltage. Since it is a voltage waveform, I am considering, if you want to take the current, you can take. No problem. Okay. So at each point, you take the voltage. And for that observation, number of observation, if you divide, you will get the average voltage. Okay, clear? Now, this is called the discrete calculation. That means from one point to one point, if no connection is there, that is called discontinuity. Okay, but see, here it is continuous waveform. So this kind of calculation may not be possible, or it will give you some erroneous value. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that's why what we are going to do, we have the voltage waveform, correct? So if we have the voltage waveform, then we will do the integration, right? And after integration, we divide it by the total time. So that will give you the waveform's average value. Okay, because see, if you take this first point, okay, just try to understand what I am telling. This is first point, this is second point, this is third point, this one is fourth point, fifth point, sixth point. So likewise, if you go, there are infinite number of points, because between one and two, there is also curve. You cannot deny it. Yes or no? So that's why here, this normal summation is not actually correct. It will give you some error. Okay, because you are not taking that middle values of the voltages, right? So that's why we do the integration. That means from lower limit to upper limit, considering all the points. That is our main thought. Okay, so that's why, look, this is your xt, okay, integration xt, and since it is propagating with respect to time, that's why dt is multiplied and integration is done. Then look, with total time period, it is divided. Okay, now just take one example, that previous example, that the equation was given at equals to a max, okay, and sine 2πft, right? So instead of this 2πf, I can write omega, because our main work is to find out that average voltage, right? So I am erasing this 2πft portion, okay? And instead of that 2πft, I am writing omega t. Is that clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Then we are doing the integration. So A max will remain outside. Okay. Only inside of this integrating portion, we need to write sine omega t into dt divided by the total time period. Okay, now this sinusoidal integration you can do just by in 15 seconds or 10 seconds, right? So this is the simple process, that whatever kind of waveform is given, you can calculate everyone's average value. That is the beauty of this system. Okay, so just like this average value of the waveform, I hope you remember that RMS value was also there.
Okay, so you have to calculate two kinds of value. One is average value, another one is RMS value. Right, so average value concept is clear. So if this kind of waveform is given, if this kind of waveform is given, the square type of waveform, then what will be your this AT? Your AT, suppose this one is V, this one is small v. Okay, try to understand. If you cannot understand, speak that, sir, please repeat again. Okay, I will again tell you. Okay, so this is your now waveform, right? Okay, just let me share the another screen. Okay, is the screen visible? Just a minute, just to give some time. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now,
yes, sir.
Okay. Now look, because this kind of numerical was given in previous year, that's why I am telling you. Okay. So be prepared for any kind of problem. Suppose this is your current waveform. Okay. This square waveform. Right, this is your current waveform, it is your A. Okay, so what is your total time period? Can you tell me? This is your suppose zero, this is this is not zero, this cannot be zero, this is 10 second, this is 20 second, this is your 30 second. Okay, so can you tell me, can anyone tell me what is the time period of this system, of this alternating system?
10 seconds,
sir.
Why 10 seconds? Because try to understand that
20 seconds,
exactly, it is 20 seconds. Why? Now the question comes, why 20 seconds? Look, this waveform starts from this point. Okay, and it reaches to zero at 10 second point. Okay, but it doesn't stop here. It is still propagating along the x-axis at zero voltage value. Exactly what I am telling, can you understand? At this 10 second moment, its magnitude becomes zero, but it does not stop here. It just propagates along this path up to 20 second. Then again, the waveform starts. Okay, so what is the full propagation? What is the full propagation of one full cycle? What is the one full cycle? One full cycle means you're up to 20 second, because after 20 seconds, the waveform again continues. Is that clear to everyone? Concept clear? Work?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if I draw, like, yes? Yes? Yes. Does anyone have any problem or any issue? Okay. So I am drawing another waveform. Try to say that. Okay, then what is the total waveform? Suppose this is your 0 second, this is 5 second, this is 10 second, this is 15 seconds. So what is the time period of this system? What is the capital T?
10 seconds.
Now you fully understood that what is the main thing, right? Now we are going to calculate the average value. Okay, now look, for this square wave system, okay, there are several kind of system. You can build one system using your own brain. Okay, you can make thing complex, you can make things very simple. It's up to you. Okay. So first, try from the simple one, that is the square wave. Okay, so for square wave, what is the total time period? Total time period is your 20 second. Okay, now what is the, our average value? A, V, G. Oh, just a minute. Hello?
Hi, ball. Ball. ঘরের একটা এ ফোর সাইজ পেজের মধ্যে এটা পরিষ্কার করে লিখে ছবি তুলে আমাকে পাঠিয়ে দে। ঠিক আছে, আমি 5টা অবধি আছি কলেজে। ঠিক আছে,
ওকে, সরি ফর দ্য ইন্টারাপশন। ওকে, নাও উই আর গোয়িং টু ক্যালকুলেট দ্য অ্যাভারেজ ভ্যালু, রাইট? সো হোয়াট ইজ দ্য ইকুয়েশন? 1 বাই টোটাল টাইম পিরিয়ড ইন্টিগ্রেশন, হোয়াট এভার ফাংশন, হোয়াট এভার বি দ্য ইকুয়েশন অফ দিস গ্রাফ, অ্যান্ড দেন ডি টি। Okay, so first we are going to calculate this AT. So what is basically AT? If you see from 0 to 10, between this time duration, what is the magnitude? That is A, correct? So I am writing like this, 0, semicolon, okay, 0, less than equal to t, less than equal to 10. Is that okay to everyone? Is this okay? Is this process okay? Can you understand this?
Yes.
Yes.
Next, we are writing 0 for the time duration 10 to 20. Okay, so now what is your total time for which you are going to calculate the average value? Your lower limit will be 0 and upper limit will be the maximum time period value, that means 0 to 20. Okay, now how to calculate? Now put the simple values of every equation you are getting. So look, 1 by t, okay, within third bracket, integration 0 to 10, because there is one change in the magnitude, that's why this division is done. Okay, so 0 to 10, and this is one fundamental property of integration, if you can remember, okay, that if there is the lower limit from t1 to upper limit t2 plus t3, then we can write, from t1 to t3, then we can write integration lower limit t1 to t2 plus integration lower limit t2 to upper limit t3. That is the basic property of integration. So we are using that property. Okay. So I am writing here a into dt, right, plus integration 10 to 20 0 into dt. Okay, so from here, 1 in place of capital T, I can write 20. Okay, then A is already constant because it is not varying. So A, and integration of dt will give you T, and its limit 0 to 10, correct? Next, plus here all value is 0. So ultimately what you are getting, A divided by 20 into 10. So what is your average value? Your average value is A by 2. Is that okay? Do you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So?
Yes, sir.
So, in similar case, this
हेलो
सर, यू आर नॉट ऑडिबल,
वीडियो इज पॉज्ड।
चलो अकेले नहीं।
हेलो सर, लीव। ओके शायद
क्या हुआ भाई, सर लीव हो गए।
हेलो, yes, yes, I am there. I am there. Don't worry. Actually, there was
so after there was what you speak, sir?
Network is from search side.
How come you know Amit?
All of us can understand our language, but search voice is not applicable on anyone.
Yeah, you're correct.
Hello, am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir. Okay. Thank God. We just got the net connection again. Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
Actually, we got disconnected twice. That is a record. Okay, fine. So let me share the screen. Okay. Just wait some time. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
fine.
Sir.
Okay, just yes, give sir. Some time. Everyone can. Okay, fine. So now, for this triangular waveform, how can you solve this? For this triangular waveform, see, the magnitude is varying. Okay, from time to time. So we are going to calculate the equation of this straight line. Okay. So, can you find the equation of this straight line? It is easy.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
okay,
sir.
Then find it. Quickly, find it. What is the waveform of this straight line? The first one, that is, I am naming it 0 to A. Okay, from A to B, from B to C, because there are three straight lines. Okay, so we need to find out this three straight line, okay, for the time 0 to t to 2.5, because this point is 2.5 second. Okay, this time is 7.5 second. Okay, so 0, so here it will be 2.5 to 7.5, correct. Then this will be 7.5 second to 10 second. So this is, so total three waveform, three equation you will get with respect to t. Okay, so how can you calculate the time? this is nothing but y minus y1. What is the coordinate of this point? That is, suppose this point is A. Okay, A is the magnitude. So we can write 2.5 comma A.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, yes. Why in the second line you set the upper limit as 7.5? The difference is 5, sir.
No, see, but the straight line, that you have to check the straight line, how much it is, what is the starting point and what is the ending point, because check, three straight lines are here now. This is your first straight line, this is your second straight line, this one is your third straight line. So where is your query?
Okay, sir.
Because see now, there are the, where is the, what is your total time period? Your total time period is 10. Correct. So you have to check what is the equation up to the 10 second. If you check that, you will get three straight lines. Straight line 1 from 0 to 2.5, straight line 2 from 2.5 second to 7.5 second, and then straight line 3 from 7.5 second to 10 second. Okay. So first straight line you can find out very easily. It will take very less time, because this equation is nothing but y equals to mx, right? And what is your m? M is the y-axis divided by x-axis, isn't it? So y-axis magnitude is a, and a-axis magnitude is 2.5. so a by 2.5x, so better saying this is 5a by 2 into x. What is your x? Instead of x, you have to write what? T, isn't it? Because the variable in x-axis is your t. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is at? At means it is the propagation, sir, of this waveform. Okay, yes.
Sir, instead of a by you put 5a.
Yes, sir.
Instead of
a by 2.5. Okay, please someone mute their microphone, because whatever noises are coming.
Sir, okay. Y is equal to mx, and in second step you wrote a by 2.5 into x.
Okay.
And third step you wrote, instead of a, at the point of a you got 5a by 2. How is this possible, sir?
Please. Yes, sir, similar question.
Okay, that will be 2a by 5. Yes, that will be 2a by 5. Yes, correct. This is 2a by 5 into t. So in first case, we are writing 2a by 5 into t. For the second case, what is your starting point? Starting point is 2.5 comma a. That is your first coordinate. And the last coordinate is your minus a, this point, right? So this is your 7.5 comma minus a. So you have to figure out what is the equation of straight line here. So find out y minus a divided by a plus a, okay, then x minus 2.5, then 2.5 minus 7.5. okay, so I am using y minus y1 divided by y1 minus y2 equals to x minus x1 divided by x1 minus x2. That process I just used. So this will be y minus a divided by 2a equals to x minus 2.5 divided by, it will give you minus 5. Okay, because look, the slope is negative here. For this equation number 2, the slope is negative. Okay, so that's why you are getting minus here. So now y minus a equals to minus of 2a by 5, right, into x minus 2.5. Clear? Now, what is the equation of
no, one? Sir.
Okay, what? Wrong again.
Yes, sir.
And we have to cross multiply, na?
Yes, the cross multiplication already done. 2a already done here, multiplication already done, and 5 I kept there in the denominator side.
Correct only, sir.
Yes. See, this cross multiplication I am not doing. I am just keeping this minus 5 here as it is. Okay. Only 2a, this denominator portion, 2a is only gets here. Is that okay?
Sir.
Yes.
So not clear.
Okay, why it is not clear? Okay,
sir, just y minus a upon a plus a equal to x minus 2.5 upon 2.5 minus 7.5 is not
yes. Okay, we are just using this
question of 2.4 question of coordinate.
Why?
Yes, here you are getting two coordinate. Okay, so using that two coordinates, can't you formulate the equation of the straight line? See, whatever process I am doing, that is not necessarily you have to follow this one. You just do your own method to calculate what is the equation of the straight line. That's all I need to know. Okay. Just calculate what is the equation of straight line. Okay. You have two coordinates, 2.5, a, and another one is 7.5, minus a. These two coordinates you have. Now calculate the Now formulate the straight line equation. Okay, that's your final one. Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Okay.
Clear.
Okay. Now calculate in your own way. Okay. Fine. So now 2a divided by 5. This is your x. Then plus. This will be 2 by 5. This will be 5 by 2. So this will give you simple a, as I can see, and this minus a will be here. This will be plus a. Okay. So now I can write here minus 2ax by 5 plus 2a. Now, what is this x? X is nothing but your time. So this will give you minus 2a minus 2a by 5 into time plus 2a. Okay, is this clear, visible?
Okay.
So now, okay, now check everyone. Okay.
Hello.
Rest solution ka hai iska sir, why maine seekh ke baad.
Sir, you are not audible.
Yes, I know. But I was disconnected again due to network problem.
Okay.
Hello, now am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. See.
Yes, sir.
I am having just... Okay, fine. So three times I just lost my internet connection here in college. Okay, so this is your final for second straight line. You are getting this equation. Okay, So before we lose any kind of internet problem, all of you give your attendances. Okay. All of you give your attendances, and this numerical, all of you try. Okay.
Sir, in chat box.
Yes. Yes. Are giving your attendance in the chat box here.
Okay.
Okay. All of you give, because in previous case, some of you were given your attendances, but I think those were not here. Okay, all of you give your attendances right now. Then I will continue. Okay, now is the screen visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So for the second straight line, this equation I am getting. Okay, now you have to find the equation for the third. Clear. So calculate the what is the equation you are getting, okay, and complete the calculation process, right? And everyone check whether you are getting this equation or not. This y equals to this, okay, this y equals to minus of 2x by 5 to at by 5 plus 2a. This one you are getting or not, everyone please check, right? And yes,
getting, sir.
Okay, fine. That means it is okay. Very good. So now from this point, from the 7.5 comma minus a, okay, just a minute. Now you have to calculate only another straight line equation, that is for 7.5 comma minus a to 10 comma 0. Okay, so this straight line you have to find out, right? And if you can do the whole process, if you can calculate the average value of this waveform, post that in WhatsApp. Today I will check everything, okay? And the previous problems, their solutions I will also give. Okay, so now just a minute. Okay, have you drawn the figure? Have you drawn the waveform?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I just stopped sharing the screen.
Sir?
Yes?
So module 1.8 of DC circuit is not in our classroom.
Yes, I know, because I told you, yesterday I didn't get any time to check this classroom things. Okay, I was a little busy. So today I will update all the details.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Okay, just a minute. Okay, so just a minute. Is the screen visible? The average value of the waveform?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine, very good. So this is the process how you calculate any kind of waveform's average value. Okay, now next one is how to calculate the RMS value of the waveform. Now RMS value calculation is similar like you are calculating the energy, you are calculating the energy, heat energy for one current you are passing. Okay, if suppose I1 current through one resistor. Try to understand what I am saying. Suppose this I1 current, 1 ampere current, okay, just take 1 ampere. 1 ampere current I am trying to flow through this 10 ohm resistance. So now you can find out the total power loss, that is I square RT. Okay, total power loss I square R, and total energy loss is I square R into T. Right. Now, if 2 ampere current you are trying to flow,
hello?
Okay, now if 2 ampere current you are trying to flow, you can calculate the another energy. If you are trying to flow the 3 ampere, then you will calculate the another amount of energy loss. Okay, now what if the total amount 1 plus 2 plus 3, so total 6 ampere current, if you can flow through this resistance, then the total amount of energy, whatever you get, that will be the summation of the previous energies. Okay, that is the basic fundamental thing, right? So from that concept, we are going to calculate the RMS value. Okay, so here look, for the first interval, that means when I1 current is flowing, this amount of calorie has been lost. Jn is divided. Okay, that is the Joule constant. Next, for second interval, that means when I2 current is flowing, this much of heat loss is occurring. Next, for third interval, next for nth interval, so likewise, the total heat produced is this. It is the summation of the previous heats. Correct. Now, what if the total amount of current is flowing in the circuit? Suppose a particular amount of current you are flowing through the circuit and you are getting the same amount of heat. Okay, so then we will equate these two, and this current, that unknown amount of current, will be the root mean square of those instantaneous current values and its squares. Okay, that means whatever previous heat loss you measured, suppose this one is X. Okay, now one certain amount of current, one unknown amount of current you are flowing through the resistance, and you are observing that same amount of heat loss is occurring there. Okay, so what is that current value? How you can calculate that current value? You can calculate like this. So whatever value you are getting, that is called the RMS current value. Similarly, if you calculate the voltage, you will get the RMS voltage value. Okay, now look, according to the previous curve, suppose this is our waveform. Suppose this is our waveform. Okay, now in this waveform, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6, I7, likewise, nth intervals value you are taking. But since it is a continuous waveform, so you have to take the integration process, right? So what is the integration process? What is the equation? The equation looks like this, that ARMS equals to 1 by total time period integration 0 to t a square t dt. Okay, so this is AT, that means whatever AT you are calculating there for each time periods, for each time, that means for 0 to T to 10, okay, then from 10 to T to 20. So likewise, these value, whatever magnitude you are getting here, suppose this is your 1 or 0, then this square, you have to do, then multiply with dt. Okay, after integration, divide it by the total time period and then root. So this is the total process of RMS value calculation. Okay, so the example based on this RMS value, I will show you in next class. Right, now just it will take only 5 minutes. Okay,
Now this example I will tell you in next class. Okay, so today this one I have to complete that previous numerical. Okay, I hope you can remember this numerical. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes.
Okay, so the numerical that was given yesterday, this is 2 ohm in parallel, some 2 ampere current source is present. Okay, next some 5 ohm is present here. Here 6 ohm is present. Okay, then this is your 5, this is your 6 ohm, this one is 2 ampere, this one is 2 ohm, and then here 5 ohm and one voltage source is here, that is of 10 volt. Okay, and it is told to calculate using superposition, right?
Yes sir.
Okay,
yes, sir.
So using superposition, two sources are present. So first you have to take using 10 volt source, and second you have to take using the 2 ampere source. Okay, so when you are considering 10 volt source, so I am doing it fast. You are considering 10 volt source, volt that upper ampere will be open circuited, right?
Yes, yes.
So here another 5 ohm in parallel, here another 6 ohm in parallel, 6 2. So either you can do here nodal analysis or your normal method. This is your 5, this is your again 5. Okay, so what I am going to do, see here, 6 2, total 8 ohm is present in this path. So I am doing here according to nodal analysis because it will save much time. So what is your input current? 10 minus V divided by 5, that is your input current. Okay, then what is your outgoing current through this path and through this path? This is your input current. Okay, so input current I just wrote here. What is your outgoing current? V by 5 plus V by 8. Okay, so now this will be 2 equals to 2V by 5 plus V by 8. Okay, so from here you can write it is 40. This is your 16 plus 5 into V, 5, 8, 8 to 16. Okay, so now the value of V you are getting as 80 divided by 21 volt. Okay, so what is the current flowing through this 6? The current flow will be 80 by 21 divided by 8, because see, 6 ohm and 2 ohm are in series. So whatever current that will flow through 6 ohm, the same current will flow through the 2 ohm also. Okay, so that's why this total path you have to take. So this will give you 10 by 21 ampere. So is this current value you are getting? Yes or no?
No, sir.
No, again. Okay, where did you, where have you done wrong? Can you identify?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that must be one silly mistake. Okay, no issue. Next time, all of you can do that. Okay, so just step by step follow the process. Clear? So here, I6, that will be 10 by 21 ampere. Okay, check that every calculation. Here it is 2 ampere, that is V by 5, V by 5. So 2 V by 5, and this is your V by 8. Okay, next V by 8. After addition, it will be 5, 8, 16, 8, 5, 40. So 21, 40 into 2, it will be 80 by
21 volt value you are getting. Next, I6 dash, and what is the direction? I am naming it AB. Okay, so direction is from A to B. Next, you have to take the 2 ampere. Okay, and at that time voltage source will be shorted. So now current source is present here. This is your 2 ohm. This is your 5. This is your another 5. Okay. Then again, it is 6 ohm. Okay. 6, 5. This is 5. Then this one is 2. This one is 2 ampere. Correct. This is your A point. This is your B point. Now look, this 5 and 5, they are in parallel. These two are in parallel, right or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so yes, sir.
Can redraw this circuit. Okay, I am just removing. No, if I remove that, it may not help you to understand. Okay, so this is your 2 ampere. This is your 2 ohm, okay. This is your 6 ohm, and here I am writing how much? 2.5?
2.5.
Sir. Okay, fine. 2.5. So 2.5, 6, and this is 2. This one is 2 ampere. Okay, now look, this 2 ampere is dividing into two paths. Correct. One is through 2 ohm, another one through this path. Correct. So I can write this circuit like this. I can draw this circuit like this. Okay. Everyone, please pay attention. This is your 2 ampere. Okay. In parallel, 2 ohm is present. In parallel, here 6 ohm is present, here 2.5 ohm is present, here 6 ohm is present. So look, there are two paths now. In parallel, one is through 2, another one is through this path. Correct? So these two paths are parallel. So you can do the current divider rule here easily. Correct. So what is the current divider rule, and through which path we need to calculate? Through 6 ohm we need to calculate the current. So I 6 double dash we need to find out. Okay, and how these 6 are 2.5 are connected? They are connected in series. Please check that here the connection is little bit different according to the shorting of the voltage source. Okay, so 6 and 2.5 are in series here. Okay, so I can write here that I 6 dash okay, am I audible? Is this visible?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
I just lost the internet connection again. Okay, fine. So I 6 dash I can write as 2 into in upper in to everyone.
sir.
Yes, sir.
It is very hectic if this is happening again and again. Okay, fine. So just a minute. This will take almost 1 minute to complete. Okay, so this is your I6 that you are getting right now. Okay, so who is joining now? No one. Fine. So now here from this point, you can calculate this 2 into 2 divided by 6 plus 2, 8 plus 2, 10. So this is your 10.5. So now, how much value you are getting? 4 divided by 10.5. That means you can write here it by 21 ampere. Okay, mute your microphone. Noises are coming. Please mute your microphone. Okay, now this, how much value you are getting? That is 8 by 21 ampere. And what is the direction? This point is A, this point is B. So the direction is from A to B. So what is your total current? I6 is the addition of this. That means 18 by 21. That means 6 by 7 ampere. Okay, is that clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I don't know who got the correct answer, but this is the actual process. Okay, if you have any type of query, your class is already over. Okay, with this numerical, if you have any kind of query regarding the numerical or the theoretical part, speak, please.
Sir, my answer is same. A 0.85, but process is, because 6 by 7 is 0.5, no?
0.85, correct.
But process is totally different.
Okay, then send me your snapshot. No issue.
Sir,
I will check.
Kya hua hai?
Okay, I will check today. What is your name? Sir. What is your Ankita name? Kumari. Okay, I will check. Then I will reply.
Okay.
Thank you, everyone. I am stopping the screen sharing.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.